For strategic, economic, and political reasons, it's natural for governments to try and source equipment from domestic providers. It's for this reason that the US market has been nearly impossible to penetrate when it comes to military sales from outside firms. The American military-industrial complex is massive, and it's much more likely for American defense contractors to be selling their products overseas to allies without their own domestic options. And so, for European plane maker and defense contractor Airbus to offer a strategic tanker to the US Air Force, well, it's ambitious to say the least. It's the reason why US contractor Lockheed Martin decided to pitch the idea of a tanker transport based on the A330 platform, all under its own name. So, in today's video, we examine what this project, dubbed the LMXT, was all about. The US Air Force has been looking ahead to determine how it will replace its aging fleet of KC-135 tankers while also maintaining an edge on the battlefield. To do this, it had a three-stage modernization project, with stages being named KC-X, KC-Y, and KC-Z, or Z. As noted by Defense News, the Boeing KC-46 Pegasus was acquired to be the KC-X, a shorter-term solution. Interestingly, Aerotime notes that Airbus partnered with Northrop Grumman and initially won the KC-X tender. However, after intense lobbying, the contract was taken away from Airbus and the tender was relaunched, with Boeing winning the contract in 2011. And so, the Lockheed Martin Airbus collaboration, known as LMXT, was meant to be the answer to the KC-Y, a so-called bridge tanker for the next 15 years, until the Air Force finds a KC-Z. The Air Force has since renamed this modernization program, but this structure was what Lockheed Martin was working with. We'll discuss that a little more later in this video. Examining Lockheed Martin's promotional material for the LMXT, it's obvious that the company is very well aware of the fact that its program needs to be American through and through. Here are just a few snippets demonstrating this. Lockheed Martin introduces the LMXT as America's next strategic tanker, built in America by Americans for Americans. It adds that production and tanker modification will occur across the USA, and this will, quote, strengthen the US aerospace industry through partnerships with existing customers and new suppliers, create a diverse workforce by maintaining and sustaining high-tech, highly skilled American manufacturing jobs, and from assembly to conversion to delivery, the LMXT will make a strong economic impact in the US. The LMXT, however, was stated to be based on the, quote, combat-proven design of the Airbus A330 Multi-Role Tanker Transport, or MRTT. Lockheed Martin goes on to say that as the prime contractor, it works directly to implement US Air Force-specific requirements within the LMXT, adding, as the strategic tanker of choice for 13 nations, the MRTT has logged more than 250,000 flight hours refueling US and Allied fighter, transport, and maritime patrol aircraft in combat theater environments. In case you were unaware, the Airbus A330 MRTT begins its life as an A330-200 and is then converted to become the military variant. In some cases, the jets are built and directly converted. In other cases, older A330-200s once used by airlines are acquired and then converted. Lockheed Martin's proposed LMXTs would have started life as A330 aircraft assembled at Airbus's plant in Mobile, Alabama. Those planes would then have gone to Lockheed Martin's facility in Marietta, Georgia, for conversion into tankers. Larry Gallagly, director of the LMXT program at Lockheed Martin, when the program still existed, told The War Zone that it would have taken between 3 and 4 years to produce each one of these planes, about 2 years to produce a green A330, and another 18 to 24 months to convert it into an LMXT.
Now, officials from Airbus and Lockheed Martin, and not to mention the state's elected officials, are excited about this, but it's all contingent on winning the contract.
Lockheed Martin's main selling point was that its LMXT offering was already a proven concept, as the A330 MRTT is already operating and has proven its abilities in the real world. It highlighted that the LMXT was quote-unquote ready now, which is clearly a statement that had more to do with design and development rather than actual production. Yes, Airbus does have a bustling facility in Mobile, Alabama, but there's no doubt that some time would have been required to set up A330 production at the site. But as time moved on, Lockheed Martin would change its mind about its proposal to the US Air Force. As highlighted by Air and Space Forces magazine, the company withdrew its LMXT aerial refueler from the Air Force's KC-135 fleet recapitalization program. Bowing out in October 2023, a company spokesperson stated, "Lockheed Martin has decided not to respond to the U.S. Air Force's KC-135 fleet recapitalization request for information. We are transitioning Lockheed Martin's LMXT team and resources to new opportunities and priority programs, including development of aerial refueling solutions in support of the NGAS program." As we alluded to earlier, the Air Force renamed the KCZ project, and so it's now NGAS, or Next Generation Air Refueling System. As it withdrew its bid, Lockheed Martin highlighted that Airbus would press on and offer its multi-role tanker transport, or MRTT, version of the aircraft directly. An Airbus spokesperson said that the European firm, quote, "remains committed to providing the US Air Force and our warfighters with the most modern and capable tanker on the market, and will formally respond," adding, "the A330 US MRTT is a reliable choice for the US Air Force, one that will deliver affordability, proven performance, and unmatched capabilities." Well, it's been a year, and we haven't really heard much from Airbus on this front. Was it a shift in the political climate? Did Airbus realize its immense uphill battle against fully American contractors? Perhaps it was a variety of factors. Ultimately, Lockheed Martin and Airbus have kept busy despite abandoning their LMXT collaboration. Airbus is developing the A330 MRTT Plus as an update to its popular MRTT program. This update will be based on the A330-800, which will thus deliver higher levels of efficiency and increased range for customers. As mentioned earlier, Lockheed Martin redirected its focus to NGAS. The firm is drafting up a rather unconventional design for this next-generation refueler, an uncrewed aircraft with a conventional planform shaped for some degree of stealth. It's a rather flat design with Air Force-style refueling booms deployed from pods on the far outboard of the wings. There are two outward cantered stabilizers at the tips of the elevators, situated far from a central exhaust. It's quite the departure from all of the large and medium-sized tankers we know today, the KC-390, KC-135, KC-46, and A330 MRTT. But, well, that's a topic we'll have to look at in a few years' time. It would be quite interesting to see Airbus set up an A330neo assembly line in Mobile. Considering the size and scale of the US Air Force and its operations, winning a contract would certainly be worth the effort. And so, what do you think of the now-abandoned LMXT project? And do you think Airbus has any hope of securing a contract with the US military on its own? Let us know by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.